students in Seth Vidya Mandir English High School and Junior College of Science and Commerce, Maharashtra Board. You are greatly welcome to this online audio-video lessons in English for Standard 10th. This is Unit 3, Lesson 1, The Knight of Scorpion by Nisim Ezekiel. Myself, Mrs. Archana Bhatija, will present this poetry with poetry lines, explanation and assignments with poetic devices. Let us know about the poet. Nisim Ezekiel was an Indian Jewish poet, actor, playwright, editor and an art critic. Fundamental figure of Indian English poetry. Padma Shri and Sahitya Academy Award winner. He writes about common themes and has enlarged Indian English poetry. He is one of the modern English poets. What is the central idea of this poem, The Knight of Scorpion? The poet depicts the selfless love of a mother who is stung by a scorpion. In spite of the pain, she thanks God that it did not hurt her children. The poem also deals with another theme about the Indian life, in which a small insect is compared to a dangerous omen. This highlights the Indian society and its superstitions. The technical aspect and the poetic devices. What is a rhyme scheme? The rhyme scheme is a pattern of the words at the end of the lines. The poem has a narrative style. This poem is in the form of a free verse having no fixed rhyme scheme and the lines are of irregular length. There are figures of speech like simile, metaphor, inversion, alliteration, tautology, onomatopoeia, antithesis and hyperbole. Please identify and explain them as you complete the poetry. On your screen, students, you have dark italic words which are the explanation along with the poetry lines. The poem begins in a village when the poet is a child, in his childhood when he stays with his mother and father in a small home. It's the son's narration after bite about the scorpion. I remember the night my mother was stung by a scorpion. 10 hours of steady rain had driven him to crawl beneath a sack of rice. Parting with his poison, flash of diabolic tail in the dark room, he risked the rain again. The poet says that after biting his mother, scorpion crawled back into the rain. The boy also remembers how people or the villagers around came to his house. The peasants came like swarms of flies and buzzed the name of God 100 times to paralyze the evil one. Here, students, you have the simile, onomatopoeia as well as the hyperbole in the same lines. As the poem proceeds, the villagers made various sounds to relieve the effect of the scorpion bite from his mother. With candles and with lanterns, throwing giant scorpion shadows on the mud-baked walls, they searched for him. He was not found. They clicked their tongues. With every movement that the scorpion made, his poison moved in mother's blood, they said. May he sit still, they said. May the sins of your previous birth be burnt away tonight, they said. May your sufferings decrease, the misfortunes of your next birth, they said. May the sum of all evil balanced in this unreal world against the sum of good become diminished by your pain. So they all prayed. The villagers searched for the scorpion to kill it. They also did chants and prayers for the forgiveness of the sins of the poet's mother in her last birth and to be relieved of the sins. As the poem proceeds, peasants hoped to bring relief to the poet's mother by their prayers and incantations to God with all their patience and sympathy. The lines are, may the poison purify your flesh of desire and your spirit of ambition, they said. And they sat around on the floor with my mother in the center, the peace of understanding on each face, but then to no relief. Later on, as the night grew deep and dark, as it rained, the poet's mother was in pain. The poet's father believed in cure and remedies rather than magic. Also, the priest tried his own ways of chanting the rites. What are the lines? More candles, more lanterns, more neighbors, more insects, and the endless rain. My mother twisted through and through, groaning on a mat. My father, skeptic, rationalistic, trying every curse and blessing, powder, mixture, herb and hybrid. He even poured a little paraffin upon the bitten toe and put a match to it. I watched the flame feeding on my mother. I watched the holy man perform his rites to tame the poison with an incantation. And finally, after 20 hours, it lost its sting. What does the poet say? He says that after suffering of 20 hours, when his mother opened her eyes, her pain subsided. In spite of her own pain, she thanked God for saving her children from the poisonous scorpion's bite. The lines are such. My mother only said, thank God the scorpion picked on me and spared my children. Students, what is the moral? The narrative appeal of the poem makes it simple and easy to understand for you. The poetry depicts selfless love of a mother, where in spite of all her pains, she wished the welfare of her children. For the self-assessment, children, please write the poetry appreciation. Find the poetry lines for the figures of speech mentioned at the start and solve all the textual questions in the notebook for your assignments. Thank you, students.